Hi, and welcome to ISBI. Today, I'm gonna turn my ordinary IKEA desk into an electronics workstation. I bought some melamine coated boards which were normally used as shelf boards. I have to cut them to the right size first. Therefore, I changed the table saw blade to a 62 saw blade to prevent any tear out on the melamine coating. Here you can see that the cut with this blade is perfectly clean. Next, I mark all the spots where I have to drill holes. I will use cam lock fittings and dowels like in IKEA furniture, so I have to drill a lot of holes. First, I drill all the holes in which the dowels will be screwed in later. Then, I drill all the holes from the edges by hand. In these holes, the dowels will be plugged in to lock it with the cam lock fittings during the assembly process. And then I drill all the holes for the cam lock fittings. Here you can see how I supported the big boards for drilling. I have to drill some holes in the middle of this big board, and therefore my wall-mounted drill press is very handy. I just lower the drill table and have a bigger reach out to drill these holes with a longer drill bit. If you wanna see how I built this wall-mounted drill press, a link to the videos is in the upper right corner and in the video description. And if you are more interested in such innovative ideas, go and check out my channel. And if you haven't subscribed yet, do that as well. And don't forget to hit the bell so you are notified every time I upload a new video. Every cut edge will be invisible later, except for one, so I add self-sticking edge band. I want to have a power outlet in the back wall of my electronics workstation. So I drill a hole for the cable and screw on the outlet. And I drill a hole for the cable of the lighting of the workspace as well. Then it was time to clear my desk. First, I attach a LED tube light to the top shelf. Then I start assemble the whole thing piece by piece. I also 3D printed the cable grommet to feed the cable for the LED tube light through. I know nobody will ever see this, but it would always bother me if I hadn't done that. Now it's just a lot of preparing the boards with these IKEA-like connector things. The nice thing about these dowels and camlock fittings is that almost no hardware like screws will be seen at the end. I think most of you will know this connection system. For all who doesn't know these things, I show quick how it works. This is such a camlock fitting in which the dowel will be plugged in. By turning this camlock, the boards will be pulled together and makes a rather firm connection. Here you can see how nice the boards will be pulled together when I turn the cam lock. I add piece by piece by preparing the boards with the hardware, set them in the right place and fasten them. Prepared with the hardware, the boards look really like they are from IKEA. The shelf itself is now done. I set some of my stuff in place to determine where I have to drill holes in the desk. Because I don't wanted any holes in the back of the shelf unit, I decide to feed the cables from my power supply and solder station through the desk. So I clear the desk once again. I then mark all the spots where I have to drill the holes for the cable grommets. I also mark and drill holes for more connection dowels so the shelf unit can be attached to the desk. Unfortunately, my hole saw does not go completely through the desktop, so I have to drill from underneath as well. Even worse, underneath the desktop is a cable channel, which makes it impossible to drill from underneath in the assembled situation. So I have to detach the desktop to drill the holes. It's very impressive to me how stable such a desktop can be, which is just filled with cardboard. Now that the holes are drilled, I can reassemble the desk again. The cable grommets I use are 3D printed. You can find a lot of such cable grommets on Thingiverse. I set the cable grommets in place and screw in all the connection dowels before I set the shelf unit in place. Then I wire the outlet and the LED tube light. I just connect the cable to them, and on the other end of the cable I connect a plug, which will be plugged in a plug strip which sits in the cable channel underneath the desk. I add a switch for the LED tube light. I decide to have this switch underneath the desktop. Therefore, I drill two holes. One for the switch and one to feed the cable through. And last, I wire the switch to the LED tube light. And then it's time to set everything back in place. Some of the camlock fittings are still visible. I bought some plastic covers to cover them up. These will be just plugged directly in the camlock fittings. Et voilà, they are almost invisible. I will show you how I have attached the switch underneath the desktop. Here you can see the two holes. Because of the cardboard inside the desktop, it was very easy to push the cable from one hole to the other. I'm very happy with the result. Not only the light for working is better, also the storage possibilities around the workspace are much better. I think with this improved desk, working with electronics is much more fun. Thank you for watching. If you like my videos, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click the notification bell and stay tuned for future projects. See ya!